You've just wrote a program that prints out Eliza's to-do list, and it probably looks somewhat like this. A counter starts at 1, it goes up to 6, we do some work, we increment the counter, keep on doing it until the counter has reached its end. There's nothing wrong with it, but if you think about it, the three statements that control the counter, the initialization, the check, and the update, they're spread all over the loop. The for loop is there to organize it a bit more neatly. Here is the basic outline of the for loop. It has 3 slots, and we fill in the right statements in each one of them, and I'll demonstrate that in this low-tech way. We'll cut out the initialization, the condition, and the update, and we'll put them in the right slot. Initialization goes here, the condition goes here, and the update goes here. Now you see they're all neatly together in the header of the for loop. Let's have a quick look at the control flow. We start with the initialization. Then we check the condition. We go into the inside of the loop. Then we do the update. Now the counter is 2. We check the condition. We go into the inside of the loop. We do the update. Now the counter is 3. We check the condition. We go inside the loop. We do the update. We check the condition. We go inside the loop. We do the update. Check the condition. Go inside the loop. Do the update. And eventually, the condition is false, and we leave the loop. Notice that the initialization happens once. The check happens before entering the loop, and the update happens after finishing an iteration of the loop.